Hey, horsey people! Man, I can feel the hate and the force coming at me on this video. Oh my God. Look, these topics are not easy to discuss. And I cover a lot of topics on all three of my channels. Think Like a Cop, we call that a clue, and Think Like a Horse. So, and I cover topics and positions that aren't popular. And I take a lot of heat and I get a lot of hate. But you know what? Somebody has to say it. We can't live in this PC world where everything has to be sweet nothings, flowers, and we can only be told what we like. And if we don't, we get triggered. We need a safe space. And we have to run and hide in a corner and sue somebody because they said something we don't like or we disagree with. The truth has many sides, and the old saying, a lie will make it around, will travel around the world before the truth has time to put his shoes on. And it's never truer in our false media and false representatives out there, and between YouTube censorship, that if somebody gets offended and enough people complain and cry and somebody makes a video calling you mean, somehow YouTube will jump in and be the truth police and the protector of, you know, bad things. This situation is a bad situation. It's sad. A child got hurt, but it is being falsely reported and only one-sided to promote one side. The truth is not being told, and I'm about to tell you the truth, and people ain't going to like it, and they're going to hate on me and think I'm picking on this poor little girl, and it's just not the case, okay? What happened to this little girl is not her fault, but she had to pay. Just like when things happen to horses, it's not their fault and they have to pay. I blame the adults. I blame parents. I blame people who should be thinking when they get around horses. And instead of that, they want to blame the horse and these mysterious, unpredictable horses. And things just happen and it's never my fault. It's always someone or something else. I don't buy it. I don't support it. And I'm going to tell my side of the story. So, Bay City girl suffers brain injury and thrown from horse. Family sinking donations. Well, this is just touch rich. Rick, how can you not understand? This is just tugs at my heart. This poor little girl in her, well, I don't see color anymore. She's just wearing a cute little shirt and a bow tie. And she's on a horse having fun. How can you pick on her? I'm not picking on her, people. I'm picking on stupid adults that put her in the position to be hurt. So the news article said this poor girl was thrown by the horse because it was spooked. And she has a skull fracture and a broken arm. Stupid horse was spooked. Damn, that's why horses are dangerous. That's why horses are unpredictable, Rick. We keep telling you this and you keep defending the horse and saying it's never the horse's fault. It's not the horse's fault, you big dummies. Horses are very predictable. Just people are too busy worrying about color and taking pictures and video and asking for money now because they do stupid things, blaming the horse. Cute kid in the hospital. Sad story. Everybody send money because stupid horse threw the horse, threw the little girl, and it wasn't her fault. And it wasn't the parents' fault to put her up there. Okay, so let's look at a different story. Besides the one where they're asking for money. Once again, news media doesn't say parents put child in risk by putting on a horse and letting the horse get spooked by another horse, putting it in a situation that caused the child to fall. No, we can't say that, Rick. 9-year-old thrown from mean, unpredictable horse. Expected to make full recovery. That's good news. But we still have to get in there thrown by horse. The horse threw the little girl. The parents did not put the little girl in a dangerous situation that got her hurt. The horse is to blame for throwing the girl. Stop reading what you read and not looking at it critically and evaluating. So they show the little girl, they show her in a hospital, and of course, this article wouldn't be complete unless somebody said, why isn't the little girl wearing a helmet? That's why we need helmets. Helmets would have saved her, Rick. She wouldn't have had the brain injury. Well, you big dummies, she was wearing a helmet. during the accident. Oops. Darn, Rick. That blew my whole helmet defense. I keep telling people helmets will keep people safe. How did she get brain injury if she had a helmet on, Rick? Helmets make people safe. I don't understand. Well, that's because you're a dummy. So let's listen to how the news represents this poor accident from the mean horse that threw her.
Blake has been riding horses since she was old enough to walk.
He is usually playful.
That's why what happened next was so unexpected.
One of the horses in the holding paddock ran up and scared her horse. When she was thrown, she hit a fence post. She was unconscious for about 5 minutes until the ambulance arrived.
Did you hear the mom? Probably a horse expert, probably trains horses. Did you hear the mom explain how the accident happened? Another horse, so now we have to blame two horses. Another horse from the paddock ran up and scared this horse. Now that's what she said, and that's what the people who don't think will hear. What I heard is, guess what? There's horses in the paddock. Maybe I should think ahead. Maybe horses run up to see other horses, and that's a natural reaction and an expected and very predictable action of a horse, that a horse will run up to another horse. Me, as a thinking person, knows this can happen. This person, the mother, Rick, she loves her child, and she has a hurt child. How dare you talk about this poor mother and child being hurt, asking for money? Well, because I see things not in a little protective, sensitive bubble, and I see things rational from a common sense level. I don't put my child on a horse around other horses when the horse, I can't control it, the kid can't control it, the horse may be spooked by another horse. I kind of think ahead and say, maybe I won't put my kid on this horse. Rick, but that's, horses are unpredictable, and you can't, You don't know what they're gonna do, and it's not. And if the kid would have had a helmet on, it would have been safe. Yeah. Keep telling the comforting lies and ignoring the hard truth, because that's what's going on in the horse world and in the whole damn world right now with the media and YouTube, Facebook censorship.
And they were able to revive her.
Jessica broke her arm and cracked her skull, resulting in a brain bleed with clotting, resulting in almost 4 hours of surgery. 33 staples and 4 stitches later, Jessica is now recovering. When asked how she's feeling today, she replied,
"Right now I have like a slight headache. But yeah, really nothing much."
Rick, how can you pick on this poor child? She's got stitches in a hospital and she's got a little purple pink stuffed animal. You're just mean and you hate women. I'm not picking on the child. Quit running your narrative that I'm picking on sex or color, or I'm trying to get people to think when you're around a horse, when horses do things that are very predictable and people blame the horse and they come up with stupid reasons like it needed a bigger bit. If she had a bigger bit, if she had a body protector on, maybe she wouldn't have hurt her head. If she had a bigger helmet, maybe she wouldn't have hurt her head. If all railing around horse stables were required to have padding, this poor little girl wouldn't hurt. So therefore, all railings around horse paddocks should have padding that's probably pink, and that way kids will be safe. It's not the padding. It's not the railing. It's not the child. It's not the helmet. It's the people that do stupid things around horses and then blame horses, and then blame me when I tell them about it. Wow.
Harper says her daughter is showing no symptoms of neurological damage, and her doctor says it's rare to see such a perfect recovery, but she has her work cut out for her when she returns home.
She'll have therapy for her arm after the brace is taken off, which she's being fitted for right after we are discharged. They've said that's going to be at least 3 times a week.
She'll also have to miss up to 2 months of school. As for climbing back on that horse again?
Sometimes things just happen. You can't just sit here and say, oh, I'll never ride a horse again, or I'll never get in a car again. That, you can't live.
So sometimes things just happen. See, when people say things like that, again, it's the horse that spooked. It's the other horse that ran from the paddock that spooked the horse. It's the horse's fault, and sometimes things just happen. All those phrases, if you look critically, is called deflection or trying to avoid personal responsibility by making this accident some unpredictable mystery that no one could ever predict would happen, because we all know horses are unpredictable. Who could predict that a horse locked in a paddock would run up to the rail to say hi to another horse? Who could predict that, Rick? That is so unpredictable. It's like the 14th myth's mystery of the earth, that horses would run to another. Nobody could predict that, Rick. Sometimes things just happen. Really? Wow. People that believe this, I mean, you just can't have two brain cells that you can't rub together and make a spark.
Life like that. Now, Jessica was wearing a helmet at the time of the accident. Kayla has set up a GoFundMe page.
Wow, that was quick. We don't want to say that too loudly. I got to give them that. At least they said that she wasn't wearing a helmet, probably because they got so many questions on was she wearing a helmet or why wasn't he, and they didn't want to get hate and beat up by the 10,000 helmet Nazis out there that were going to attack their station. Why is that kid riding a horse without a helmet? That's unsafe. That kid should have had a helmet on. The kid did have a helmet on, and they got it out there very quickly, because we don't want people thinking that wearing a helmet, they could still actually get hurt. So let's not concentrate too much on a helmet. Wow. Hopefully you got something out of this. I'm not picking on a poor child. Child did nothing wrong. I blame the parents. And what amazes me is that the parents have enough to have a saddle, a horse. They can feed a horse. They can care for a horse. But now they need a GoFundMe account to buy a car to take the child to the doctor. If you can't have a car to take your child to the doctor, maybe you shouldn't have a horse. Rick, why are you picking on the parents and the child? Shut up, you big dummies. I'm trying to make you think and use your head for more than a helmet holder. We'll end that there. Buddy, Miss T, you're good boys.